In today's video, I'm going to show you how to wire your Seachoice automatic bilge pump to a 3-position panel switch. Hi guys, this is Phil with Seachoice. I have with me today our 600 gallon per hour automatic bilge pump, which is part number 19341. I also brought with me our 3-position bilge pump switch, which is model number 19381. And for our power source, I'm using a DC power supply to simulate a 12 volt battery. Before we start making the connections, let's take a look at the switch. The switch has 3 positions, manual, on, and off. Manual indicates the momentary on position, which means the switch is manually held in position to test the pump or to make it run for a short period. As the switch is released, it springs back to the off position. The on position is where the pump normally operates. In this position, the pump's internal float switch makes the pump turn on and off as the water rises and falls. Okay, let's begin wiring the bilge pump to the switch. I've already heat shrinked the 16-14 gauge female disconnects to the wire leads of the pump. First, we want to get power to the switch by connecting it to the power source. Using 16 gauge wire, follow the wiring diagram included with the pump and connect terminal 2 on the switch to the power supply. For the 600 gallon per hour pump, make sure you have a 5 amp fuse installed between the pump and the battery. Now that we have power to the switch, we can begin to connect the pump wires. First, connect the black wire with the brown stripe from the bilge pump to ground. For the ground, I'm using the negative battery terminal. Next, take the brown wire with the white stripe and connect it to terminal number 3 on the switch. Then connect the remaining solid brown wire to terminal 1 on the switch. This completes the wiring process and your Seachoice automatic bilge pump is now ready for operation. The wiring diagram and complete instructions are available for download at seachoice.com. I'll provide a link in the description below. Now that we're all wired up, let's see the switch and pump in action. If you flip and hold the switch in the man position, it will activate the pump. When we release the man position, the pump stops pumping and we return to the off position. Now I will flip the switch to the on position, which will engage the automatic function of the pump. Right now, the water level is not high enough to trigger the float within the pump. I will slowly add water to simulate the bilge filling with water so we can see the auto feature at work. The water level got high enough to raise the float inside the pump, which activated the automatic pump feature. Once the water returns to a low level, the pump will stop pumping. Connecting your Seachoice automatic bilge pump to a 3-position switch is just one way to wire it. Depending on what you want to do, there are a number of other popular methods for connecting and operating your pump. The instructions included with the pump will walk you through each method. That's all for today, guys. Please like this video if you found it useful. Also, go ahead and subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. And remember, whether you're new to boating or an old salt, Seachoice is the quality choice.